Hey everybody, welcome to this video review. Today I have for you guys this Asus MemoPad 7 tablet. This is an Android tablet with an Intel Atom processor. But before we start, I want to show you guys what's included here. As you guys can see, I have the box right here. I have a case and I also have a micro SD card memory. And the reason why I have this here is because they are selling this tablet as a bundle. As you guys can see right here on the box. And this is at Best Buy. And basically what's included with the tablet, it's this really nice case. You can fit right here. It says 7-inch or 8-inch fits most tablets. Really nice looking case. Also included, it's a micro SD card, 16 gigabyte size. This is free. There's no extra cost, neither for the micro SD card or for the case. So this is how the box looks like. So with that, let's go ahead and take a look at the tablet and see what we have here. And let's go ahead and start with the look on the outside. As you guys can see, we have the Asus logo on the back with the shiny aluminum brush look. We have the rear camera. A volume rocker here on this side, power bottom. On top we have the USB port, 3.5 millimeter audio jack. On this other side we have the access to the micro SD card. On the bottom of the tablet we have a microphone right there. On the front of the tablet we get the Asus logo at the bottom, and we get the front facing camera, and we get a stereo speaker all the way across the tablet on top. Now let's talk about the specs. As far as the specs, and I have the tablet already turned on, and let's go ahead and unlock the screen. We have, like I said, a 7-inch display. Resolution is 1280 by 800. Pixel density, it's a little low with 216 PPI or pixel density. As far as the sound, like I said, there is a stereo speaker here on top, only one speaker. The tablet comes in 8 or 16 gigabytes of internal storage with 1 gig of RAM, and it supports micro SD card up to 64 gigabytes. As far as the cameras, we have a 2 megapixel front facing camera. The rear camera, it's a 5 megapixel. According to the specs, it says that it can shoot video in 1080. However, when I was trying to use the camera and do video recording, the maximum resolution that I found was 720, so we're going to take a look at that later. Operating system, Android KitKat. As far as the CPU, we have, like I said, an Intel Atom quad-core 1.86 gigahertz, which is something different. I don't think I've seen Android tablets with Intel Atom processor. Usually it's Windows. As far as the battery, they are claiming about 10 hours of battery life, and this is Wi-Fi. So let's go ahead and start with the interface of the tablet. Let's go ahead and lock the screen and start from there. When you unlock the screen or just tap the power button, you're gonna get this interface here. And as you guys can see, it's showing, it's gonna show the time, it's gonna show the day, the month, etc. It's gonna give you a little information of the weather, and you get three icons right here. If you press them, you can go ahead and unlock the tablet from there and access that application. So for example, that's the camera. So that's gonna take you to the camera. We also get access to email and access to the browser from the lock screen. Let's see what else we have. Other than that, it shows you right here information on the weather application. And again, you can unlock that and it's gonna give you the information. So back now to the home screen. This is how the tablet looks like. We have a little indicator right here at the bottom. So we get three screens. I believe as you are downloading apps, you're going to be getting more screens. As you guys can see, there is a weather widget and the time on top. And then here at the bottom, we have the back home and recent applications. And that's how the recent applications looks like. We can swipe with our finger to close the applications. As far as the notifications on top, this is how the notifications look like. There is no auto brightness, so you have to do it manually. There is no proximity sensor or light sensor here on top, just the front-facing camera. Now we get three different icons here on top. The first is access to the main settings of the tablet. Let's go back. The other one is access to edit the quick settings. So if we tap right there, you can go ahead and move around the order for the quick settings icons. And then the last one, it's gonna show you information on the weather. So that's as far as the notifications on the top and the quick settings. As far as the app drawer, this is how the app drawer looks like. And as you guys can see, the tablet looks actually and feels pretty quick, no lag at all. We get right here in the corner, apps and widgets. And these are the widgets. And then back here to the apps, you also get a search menu, an icon to take you to the Android Market, and a menu right here in the corner to lock app settings, hide on hide, on install, disable, sort by, and manage applications. So that's as far as the app drawer. Why don't we go ahead and take a look at the camera interface? So when it comes to the camera interface, we just press right here. And this is how the interface looks like. I actually like the interface. It looks nice, easy to understand. We tap right here to take pictures. And as you guys can see, take pictures are pretty quick. I'm gonna show you guys samples of pictures and videos later. This is the video recording option. And it gives you the option to pause the video. There's a timer here at the bottom. You can continue the recording and then stop the recording. Right here on top, we get access to the gallery or the last picture or video taken. On the other side, we get access to the front-facing camera. We get access to some filters here. And as you guys can see, it offers some nice, cool-looking filters. There's a sepia grayscale, Lomo. So it offers several filters here. That's actually really cool. And then the bottom one, it gives you access to the settings of the camera. It offers access to the white balance, ISO exposure, camera resolution, shoot mode, self timer. Here's the video quality size. And as you guys can see, the highest is 720. That will be the highest video resolution, but I mean, you're still getting high definition video. So that's as far as the camera interface. Why don't we go ahead and take a look at a couple of samples of pictures and video. So this is the gallery interface, guys. And then you get some section here as far as the gallery. You can access all photos, events, people, my cloud. So here's the camera. And let's go ahead and take a look here. These are some of the pictures that I just took while I was showing you guys the recording mode. And it gives you the option to pause, continue the recording. And let's go ahead and take a look at some other pictures here. This is a picture taken with the rear camera in the 5 megapixel resolution. This is another picture, and I apologize guys for the glare, but this is another picture taken with the rear camera. And this is a video, as a matter of fact. Let me go ahead and turn up the brightness. All right, guys, and here's a video sample.
Tomado con la cámara trasera en resolución de 720. Vamos a pausar el video. Continuamos la grabación.
So there you have it. Those are some samples of pictures and video. Keep in mind, guys, if you get the impression that the quality is not the best, you're not going to buy this tablet based on the camera. Like I said, this is a bundle, and this is actually a really, really affordable tablet at just $135, including the case and including the SD card. So overall, seems to be a really good tablet. However, it looks like maybe the camera doesn't give you the best quality, but you still get the video recording in 720 and 5 megapixel rear cameras. So let's go ahead and take a look at the performance of this tablet by playing some high graphic game. Alright guys, here's a look at Google Maps in the satellite mode. And let's go ahead and do some navigation here. Navigate to Kansas City, Missouri.
Head east on Comstock Avenue towards South 35th Street.
So as you guys can tell, I don't know if you can tell or not, but the speaker gets actually pretty clear and loud. And guys, here's a look at the browser, the stock browser that comes with the tablet. You get preloaded here, several websites, or most visited. You can do bookmarks. You get the back and forth, refresh. You can click on the plus to add a tab. Favorite right there with the star. You can search. You get a menu option right here in the corner. You can do the incognito tab. You can also request a desktop site. And under the settings, you get under accessibility the option to force enable zoom. So you can go ahead and zoom from every page, every website. So that's as far as the settings there for the browser. Let's go ahead and access here, for example, MSN page. Let's go ahead and zoom in. So as you guys can see, zoom in, zoom out. Very responsive, no issue. Let's go ahead and access one more page here. And let's go to Yahoo. And like I say, guys, we're connected to a Wi-Fi network. And I'm going to go ahead and zoom in so you guys can see how clear the text looks like. So it doesn't look bad, to be honest with you. So this is as far as the browsing experience. Couple of interesting apps here that comes with the tablet is the File Manager. Also comes with an application called Movie Studio. Looks like it's going to allow you to create movie clips. And you can go ahead and set a title there. And click on the plus right here. Takes you to the gallery. You can go ahead and select some clips and add more clips here into your timeline and save the movie. The tablet also offers a power saver mode for the battery. You get the web storage from Asus. So this is pretty much all the most important things, guys, about this tablet. So with that, I want to thank you for watching this video. Final conclusions on this tablet, to be honest with you, I think overall usage, the tablet should be okay. During the game Nova 3, I noticed there was a lot of lag, and also there was some lag when loading the Yahoo page for web browsing. So as far as the performance, apparently this is not offering the best performance. I will say very general things, you should be okay. The price on this tablet, like I said, it's around $135. They sell it as a bundle. Like I said, you're going to get the case, you're going to get the SD card, a good speaker. You can record in 720p with the rear camera. You get the Asus, and it feels really nice on the back. Intel Atom processor. So guys, I want to thank you for watching this. Subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you on the next one.